Hi, I'm Haley from the Comfy Cottage. I'm so glad you've chosen to do our Hearts Beginner Needlepoint Kit. In this class, I'm going to teach you two different stitches. You're going to learn how to do these hearts, which will be the road stitch. All of the nine hearts are the same stitch, and you'll be learning the Alicia's lace, which is the background, with a variation of including a bead in the center of each lace. To begin our first stitch, you will need to grab your canvas, and it will have all of your hearts painted. We have three different shades of purple. The first one is going to be the 211. The middle shade is going to be the 209. And the darkest shade is the 208. These are all DM Safe floss, and they are included in your kit. I'm going to do the darkest thread as it's easiest to see on the camera. You'll need to cut out enough thread to cover the heart, which is about 36 inches. It seems like a lot, but you definitely do not want to run out of thread while stitching the heart. You'll want to separate all of the plies and thread your needle. You can do a waist knot to start this stitch, or you can do this little trick of just pulling your thread up and then down and leaving enough of a tail to kind of lock it in. Because we're gonna, at the very end of the stitch, we're gonna tie off that underneath the heart. Here is a diagram to explain just how the Rhodes heart is done. I will have your canvas marked with two black dots. This will be the first stitch in a number of stitches for the Rhodes heart. You can also follow along with the diagram that comes in your stitch guide. Make sure you hold on to your tail just on the first couple stitches to make sure it doesn't come out. And you're going to start in the lower left-hand part of the heart and go up to the middle. It's best to look at the diagram to be exactly sure where to place your thread, or follow very closely to the video. You're basically going along just on the outside of the painted area of the heart. You're going to go just above and to the right of the first stitch and come down. And you're going to continue to go diagonally. And go down just to the right of the top of the stitch. If you've ever done a Rhodes circle, a Rhodes heart is very similar. You're basically still creating a spokes, but instead of a circle, they're kind of spokes of a crooked circle, but in the shape of a heart. And I'm going down. I've gone down three times on the right side. Now this stitch here will tell you if you've counted correctly all of the stitches, because it will line up perfectly straight on the canvas. If it's not, you may want to have to pull your needle out and backstep a little bit to see where things got off count. Now I'm going to go on the left-hand side. There'll be three. I'll come up three times right next to each other diagonally. And I'm going to be going down on the right-hand side of the heart. Again, always just following on the outside of the painted area. Okay, we're going to do our last couple stitches. You may have to move the thread just a little bit to see underneath where you've already stitched. But you're basically just stepping down one row. And then your last stitch is going to be exactly in the middle and down. And this will come over the one unpainted thread. And to lock it in, I'm going to go up. I'm going to turn my canvas up over and go up and then sideways. You may want to do this a couple times just to make sure everything is completely secure. And I know I have a lot of extra thread, but it's okay. You have plenty in your kit to suffice these extra tails. You can see I've grabbed the extra thread that I left tied on the side, and I'm going to lock that in as well, going up and then to the side. Just a couple times, making sure it's tight. You don't want to do it too many times to where you have a huge knot, but a little knot won't affect anything. And once all of that is tight and locked in underneath the rose heart, take your scissors and trim that off so that none of your thread tails are showing behind the white canvas. As our next step will be the Alicia's Lace, and it is an open stitch, allowing the canvas to show through. And if there's threads behind, you don't want to see those when you're done. So here's all my hearts stitched. They're all exactly the same. And all of them are tied off on the back. No tails and no threads hiding anywhere. Straight threads hiding anywhere. Now we're going to start the Alicia's Lace. The Alicia's Lace will cover the entire background behind the purple hearts. It's a three-step process to do this background. And we'll be using the DMC Floss 3813 to stitch the background. This diagram will quickly explain all three steps. The first step of the Alicia's Lace is to start in the upper right-hand corner and make continuous diagonal stitches from the top right to the bottom lower left-hand corner. Step 2 of the Alicia's Lace is rotating your canvas 90 degrees. Once your canvas is turned 90 degrees, you will begin stitching in the upper right-hand corner, the diagonal stitches continuing all the way to the lower left-hand corner. The last and final step of the Alicia's lace is the variation of adding the bead. You will rotate your canvas counterclockwise 90 degrees to have it back in the original position, and you will begin adding the beads in the upper left hand diamond and continue all the way to the right, down to the next row, and back to the left, and continue this process till the end of the canvas. To begin your Alicia's lace, you're going to want to use your DMC floss that you plied into three threads and tied a knot at the end. We're going to add our waist knot onto the left-hand side of our canvas so that we have a long tail to lock in. This may seem excessive, but with open stitches like this, I like to have extra thread. We're going to count over from the second row of holes, four holes, and go up that fourth hole. And we're going to go diagonally over, skipping one hole and down into the third hole. Second stitch, we'll skip a hole and go up. Skip a hole and go down. We're going to count down three holes and go up through the fourth hole, directly below the last stitch. We're going to skip a hole and go down. Now we're going to go back up the canvas, skip a hole, go up, skip a hole, go down. Skip a hole, go up, and then down. You should be going down in the same hole of the previous stitches. They will lock together. Each row goes into the same hole. We'll count over three holes, come up, and go down. Once you begin to have rows, it becomes much easier and you don't have to count. You should be able to see the pattern forming. You should start to see the diagonal lines. Always refer back to your stitch guide if you need help. I'm skipping down three holes and coming up through the fourth hole. I'm going to continue on this last row so that you can see where to compensate your stitches. This is one last stitch over two intersections. Now my next stitch is going to be very close to the purple heart, and I'm only going to go over one intersection. This is a compensation stitch. I'm still following the same pattern, my stitch is just not as long. Same with this stitch, over one intersection. Now that that one's done, my next stitch will continue over two intersections. You'll always work around the hearts, coming as close as you can to the canvas, but without intersecting the purple hearts. When you run out of thread, always run your thread underneath, horizontal or vertically, so that you don't warp the canvas. And if you stay closer to the edge, it will prevent the threads from showing through. This is a light enough color that it shouldn't show through the back. Once you have finished the first step of the Alicia's lace, you should have diagonal rows starting in the upper right-hand corner and going all the way to the bottom left-hand corner. Perfectly straight. The next step will be creating the diamond lattice shape pattern of the Alicia's lace. To do so, you'll want to rotate your canvas 90 degrees and you will repeat the first step, starting in the upper right hand corner, creating diagonal stitches all the way down into the bottom left hand corner. You will use the same thread, three plies, knotted, and you will create another waist knot, or the easiest way, because we have threads behind the canvas now, is to just lock in your canvas by going either horizontally or vertical, closest to your nearest stitch. I'm going to go ahead and do a waist knot again. This is personal preference, either way will work. The best part about the second step is that you have an outline for where each of your stitches should go. The steps should go super fast and be very enjoyable. I'm going to do this last row here so that you can see where my compensation stitches will go. For this one, I'm going over one intersection. This one, I'll have to kind of work around the purple heart, but only going over one intersection. And back to longer stitches. You'll continue this all the way down into the lower left-hand corner. Once you have this completed to the lower left-hand corner, you'll turn your canvas back up, counterclockwise, and you will see that you've created your Alicia's Lace lattice work. And you can proceed to the final step of adding the beads. For the last step, we're going to add the beads in the center of our Alicia's Lace. As you can see, our Alicia's Lace has all been stitched and created a beautiful lattice. And in the center of each diamond, we're going to add one of our glass beads. With your kit, you will receive a baggie of glass beads. And to attach the beads, you'll have a beading needle. And you'll use one strand of the same DMC floss used for the background. If you have a thing of masking tape or scotch tape, pretty much any tape will do. Cut yourself off a piece of that. This is just an easy tip to prevent your glass beads from rolling away from you. Pour out just a few of the beads onto the sticky tape so that they're at easy reach to begin your beading. They also make little containers with sticky goo inside of them for this purpose, but this is a quick, easy way to get around that. To start, I'm going to turn my canvas over and lock in my thread. Because it's only one ply of the floss, I like to make sure that it's fairly secure. To begin adding our beads, we're going to start in the upper left-hand corner in the first diamond. And the stitch will go over two threads. And before we go down, we're going to grab one of our glass beads. And the beading needle is small enough that it'll go all the way through the glass bead. But it won't go through the hole. The bead won't go through the hole. Make sure that you pull it tight enough so that the bead falls perfectly in the hole of the center of the diamond. You will continue this all the way to the right-hand side of the first row and then down to the next row. As you can see, I've done practically all of the canvas with the beads. I'm going to do the last bit for you so you can see how I finish off my canvas. I hope you've enjoyed this video so far. If you have a chance, tell us below what you think of the class and what other classes you might like to see in the future. We always like to know what you're thinking. And please share if you know someone that would like this class. Here are the last three holes that I'm going to fill with my beads. And the last one. And here is the final project. All of my Alicia's lace has been added, with the beads adding the perfect shimmer to this project. You have a beautiful gradient with all of the rose hearts. I hope you enjoyed this project. To see more like it, click on the videos below. Also, subscribe to our newsletter so you can always be up to date on things happening at the Comfy Cottage. And please click on the YouTube subscribe button below to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can see all of our great stitching tutorials. Thanks again for watching. Happy stitching!